I think optometry has to be part of the overall vision science research program in the United States and the world today to be considered a viable profession. I do not think, as a profession, optometry can just take other people's research results and interpret them and incorporate them into patient care. So I think things that are looking to treat and ultimately cure macular degeneration, that are looking to figure out why people become myopic and figure out how that might not happen to them, to figure out better ways to treat and cure presbyopia, as well as a variety of ocular diseases that we can now treat. If we do our own research, we are by definition the leaders in all of those efforts, from the bench to the chair side.
We have a variety of research projects ongoing here in the college. The primary bulk of those are clinically related, clinical trials related specifically to refractive error for the most part, basically understanding how we see and what kinds of things we can do to intervene to help us see better. Also understanding how vision problems change over time with respect to gender, with respect to race. All of these things allow us, number one, to provide treatment, but also to perhaps learn things about how to prevent or to ameliorate conditions that currently we cannot deal with. We also have some research activities that are going on with respect to older eyes, tear deficiencies, etc., and we have clinicians and researchers who are working with other disciplines here on campus to better understand how tear quality changes with time and how we can intervene to relieve conditions or relieve symptoms of discomfort. We also have individuals on our faculty who are doing research in color vision or color naming, very innovative and novel research. We find that although we assume that people all see and appreciate colors the same, we find that there are variations throughout the world. And so all of these better help us to better understand vision and as it relates to people and their ability to function in society.
I think vision research in the last 10 years in optometry, in schools and colleges of optometry specifically, has really become more sophisticated and has kept up more with research in the area of vision science in general. So we see basic scientists in our schools and colleges of optometry who are working on things in the lab that can ultimately be translated to patient care. We've also seen, quite honestly, especially in the last 15 or 20 years, more sophisticated patient-based or epidemiological research that really, 20 years ago when I graduated from optometry school, no one in optometry was doing. So things that look at risk factors for disease, things that look at randomized clinical trials to treat optometric conditions, all that's new to our profession.
An experience that I've had that has given me extreme personal satisfaction, I guess the one that comes immediately to mind is an occasion in which I was doing a research project in Alabama, a research project to examine young children to determine how their eyes changed over time as part of the CLEAR project, which is a major project that's being conducted here at OSU. During the course of this experiment or this project, we would bring children in, examine various aspects of their eyes, refractive mostly in nature. And there was this little girl who was a first grader who came in along with two other little boys. And I love children, so I was interacting with the children. And I asked her, well, how are you, sweetheart? And she basically didn't respond. And the two little boys that were with her, one of them said, don't talk to her. She's stupid. And I told them, don't ever say that about someone. That's not very nice. Found out later that this young girl had something called aphakia. She did not have the crystalline lens within her eye, and so therefore she couldn't really see either far away or up close. She was had a very, very high refractive error. We detected that. We were able to provide care for her by, number one, alerting her parents, but also arranging for her to get that care because she was from a family that was impoverished and really could not afford to provide that care for her. Well, the next year, when we had the battery students who were in this project come through again, this little girl came through, this time with a pair of glasses with rather thick lenses, but totally different. Instead of being quiet and retiring, she was now engaging and talking and playing with the other children. And so I appreciated then that when you talk about eye and vision problems, it's not just whether someone sees 20/20 or not. It's a quality of life issue. Suddenly she was aware of her world, able to interact with her classmates and with others in a meaningful way, because now she could see people and appreciate them.
I am excited about this research endeavor in optometry because we need it, because I feel like there have been a group of people over the last 20 years that have been able to advance it to make real differences. And then the real answer to your question is, we get to find out the answers to these questions. I have a colleague who describes the perfect researcher as someone who is terminally curious. They ask questions all the time. The luxury of getting to answer those questions makes for a great job and ultimately a great profession of optometry.